Hey guys, welcome to the video. I just wanted to start this one off again by saying thank you to all the new subscribers. The channel has actually been taking off pretty well lately. I want to start with a huge shout out to everyone who has recently been watching my videos. Today, we're going to take a look at the rear-wheel drive cars in Dirt Rally 2. I get a lot of questions about this and how to make the cars so that they're not so squirrely. The rear-wheel drive cars, especially the Group B rear-wheel drive, which is what I'm going to be using in today's video. So I'm going to show you guys how to set that car up so that you can actually drive it instead of spinning in every corner. So here we are in Australia. Group B rear-wheel drive Lancia 037, or also Lancia, if you want to pronounce it correctly. Now, a lot of people have a really hard time with some of the rear-wheel drive cars, and it mainly all comes down to, number one, because it's a rear-wheel drive car, so you really need to make sure that you're controlling the throttle in the corners. If you give it too much, you're going to spin out. However, one of the big problems with the rear-wheel drive cars is they tend to get really bouncy and squirrely in the rear end. So I'm going to do one quick run just to kind of show you this is a bone stock setup. I don't even have the option to reset tuning, so this is exactly how the car is going to come. And so I'm going to show you kind of what the car does and how to fix that.
Go. 50, 6 left 30, turn square right, into 3 left long.
So the reason I chose Australia is because the road in Australia is kind of bumpy, so it'll give you a really good idea of what this car is going to want to do on a slightly rougher terrain.
Into 5 right.
With all the power at the rear of the car, some of these little rough, bumpy sections with corners and everything are really going to kind of accentuate some of the downfalls of a rear-wheel drive car. So that right there was one. I kind of caught it, but that's just an example of what the car can do when you're taking a turn in a bumpy section. There was another one right there. That one's always really rough in this car.
Opens 80. That middle of a very long crest. 50. 6 right.
So coming through this section is another good example as well, because it's bumpy and you need to make slight adjustments here. And you can notice when I'm in the air or taking a high speed corner where there's a lot of bumps, I'm trying to go easy on the throttle, because otherwise, if I was full on the throttle and I hit the ground with the wheels spinning at full RPM, what's going to end up happening is, number one, I'm going to land in a bad direction. The wheels are already spinning, and then as soon as they bite, it's going to throw the car. Oh, that one was my fault. That was a bad line. But
30.
So you're going to land crooked, the wheels are already spinning, it's going to throw your car in a bad direction, and then just because of the nature of how this car is set up right now, it's going to want to spin. So let's head back to the surface area, and I'll show you some fixes that can correct this problem. So we're back here in our service area. So we're going to go to the Tune Vehicle tab, obviously. The very first thing we're going to do is we're going to take this toe angle. It's already at positive 20 degrees in the rear. So what this is going to do is this is going to angle your wheels inward. So if I go all the way here, you can see, well, my foot cam is kind of in the way, so just look at the top wheel. But you can see that the angle of that wheel is going to change. So what that's going to mean is, and every car on the road has a little bit of camber already in it. So what this does is, as you're driving, your rear wheels are pointing inward, so they're fighting each other. This is going to help keep that car going in a straight line easier, so you have to do less work to keep the rear end from sliding out of you, especially in corners, which is going to be the biggest problem here with the rear-wheel drive cars. So what I usually do, and especially in this car, I usually will put this car at about a positive 0.6 degrees. This is going to help a lot. So that's going to be your number one thing to do. I'm not going to mess with camber anymore because, well, these two things that I'm going to show you how to do are going to be more helpful than camber. Camber does help, but this is going to help more with that. So we've got our alignment. We've got our rear toe angle at about a positive 6. You can do positive 4 sometimes depending on the car. This is kind of a longer car, but it also has more horsepower. So I'm going to go with a positive 0.6, and we'll just see how that works out. So then the next thing you're going to do is come over to your damping. Damping, you can leave your slow bump however you want. I'm not going to touch them. I'm going to do just these two things, again, to accentuate how important just these two settings are. So we're going to go to our slow rebound, which in my previous video, I kind of described what slow rebound does. And so we're just going to take, and we're just going to put this for right now. We'll just put it at a positive 2. I said earlier there was two things. There's actually going to be three things we're going to try. Never mind. We don't have to. So it's just these two on this car. So we'll go ahead, hit apply, and we'll take this car out to the stage, and we'll see what kind of a difference those changes made.
Go. 50. 6 left 30, turn square right, into 3 left long, opens up a crest, into 5 right long, tightens 2, opens up a crest.
So already the car itself is not wanting to slide out as much as it did,
into 5 right.
And when it does, it's a little bit slower and easier to catch.
Into 3 right tightens.
Just by doing those couple things.
Into
so, long, again, with the toe angle being where it was, the car is, the rear end is going to naturally want to straighten itself out more. So, that means, the downside to that is that you're not going to be able to drift around corners quite as easily. But the benefit is that you won't have an unexpected oversteer. So like that right there. I still got a little bit of it, but it was nowhere near as bad, and it was much more controllable. And that's what we're looking for. You can still slide the car out and drift around a corner if you want to, but it's going to keep the rear end of the car much more intact. And so again, right here, I'm on the throttle a lot more than I was before because I don't have to worry about the violent compression and decompression of the springs. So I can take this section a lot faster without having to worry about the stability of my car quite as much.
Into 2 left tightens. Into 3 right tight long. 30.
Because one of the other things that will cause a lot of the oversteer in this car, especially in some of these rougher sections,
30.
Is when your wheels start bouncing violently, that obviously means a loss of traction. So by having the rebounds set stiffer, those springs are not going to oscillate quite as violently as they would have before. And that's going to allow your car to be much more stable because it's not having to deal with those springs bouncing and the weight of the wheel reciprocating over and over again.
Into 4 left long. Into 4
now,
right
this
long.
Can be applied opens. To every rear-wheel drive car. Again, I just picked the Lancia 037 because left. A lot of people are not really a big fan of driving this car, right. Specifically because of how squirrely it can be. I actually 30. Personally think this car is much more stable in Dirt Rally 2 than it was in Dirt Rally 1. In Dirt Rally 1, this car was a handful. Left. It was an absolute handful.
Middle of a crest, 40,
so,
three left of a crest,
just by making these
long,
couple little 50. These couple little changes, you can make your car much more stable and predictable. So again, I'm still sliding in this corner because it's rough, 30, and I've thrown slow, the car's weight to get that angle, but it's much more predictable
right long,
than it would have been in its stock setup. And this is another really good one too, where we're doing a lot of weight shifting, throwing the car around at different angles,
into six right of a crest,
and we
30,
can catch the car a little bit easier and bring it around and the stage with a faster time. And we don't have to be quite as careful with the throttle. You still have to be careful with the throttle, but you don't have to be quite as careful with the throttle as you would have before. One other thing to keep in mind also is You know, as I said, you can adjust camber. That's going to give you a little bit more grip in the corners as well. You can see this car naturally comes with more camber in the rear than it does in the front. And so as you're turning, that's also going to give the rear of your car more grip. Even with that, without making this rear toe adjustment and also this slow rebound adjustment, the rear end of the car is going to be much more unstable than it typically would have been. So you can try that across any rear-wheel drive car. It's, you know, actually, I should have used the old Ford Escort, because that car is very short, and the rear end on that car is very, very snappy because it's so light. But you can do this exact same thing, and actually, this is the same. These are the same adjustments I make in all my rear-wheel drive cars, and it helps so, so much. One other thing you can do with your springs. Again, this one already comes this way. They're already pretty soft. You can actually soften your rear spring rate, and that's going to help, again, absorb a lot of those bumps, keep the rear wheels of the car in contact with the ground. That's going to give you more grip. That's also going to make the car more stable. So that's another thing you can do. This is already set pretty soft. So in this specific car, in this location, I'm probably not going to mess with that too much. And in this car, it's not an option, but in some other cars, it is your anti-roll bar. You can also... You can soften that up a little bit too, and again, that's just going to free the rear end of the car up to flex a little bit more, absorb the bumps and any unevenness in the track surface. Basically, anything you can do to keep the rear end of the car more planted as you're driving is going to help with the spins. And you're also going to have to the slow rebound is going to help with that weight shift. Because you don't want to shift the weight of your car too much. You know, with the whole physics behind how a Scandinavian flick works is you're building up that weight and then you're throwing all that weight on one side. So with your slow rebound set high, it doesn't allow for such a massive and quick shift in weight. So that's what's going to help probably the most over any other setting is going to be your slow rebound. Bump your slow rebound up a little bit firmer. It's going to keep the rear end of that car from throwing its weight around so much, and that's really going to help you keep your car much more controlled and balanced in the rear-wheel drive cars as you're going through. So guys, that's it for the video. I really hope that this kind of answered some of your questions. If it didn't, please let me know in the comments. I can try to make a better one that explains it a little bit more in depth. But for the most part, this should help a lot of you guys get the rear-wheel drive cars to be much more stable and controllable. A lot of it has to do with, number one, throttle control. That is the most important thing. Even if you don't make these changes, just being aware of your throttle coming out of corners, and especially in bumpy sections where you're trying to turn your car, that's going to make a lot of difference just right there. You add these two adjustments on top of that, and that's going to make a rear-wheel drive car so much easier to drive. And in my opinion, they are the most fun class of car to drive for that reason. They're challenging, but if you make these setup changes, it's going to drastically improve the stability that you have in the car, and hopefully should improve your stage times. So thank you guys for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please be sure to hit that like button. You can also subscribe to the channel. I've gotten a huge explosion of new subscribers recently, so I really appreciate that. And again, if you have any further questions, be sure to type them down in the comments section. And also, if you have any more questions that you would like me to ask in real time, you can always catch me on twitch.tv/roadsidetv. I stream Dirt Rally every Thursday at 4:30 p.m. U.S. Central Time. So you can go and check me there, ask me questions in chat, and I can try to answer them as I'm playing. So with that, thank you so much for watching, guys. Have fun on the stages.